Hello everyone, my name is Carlos, and I have a very inspiring story for you. I come from a very poor family, and I have found a way to help them and improve our lives significantly. My dad illegally immigrated in the US when I was only 3. In our country, we were dying of hunger, as it was impossible to get a job. My mom was pregnant with my younger brother, and our only hope was money my dad could send us. In the meantime, he was trying to legalize himself so that we could join him and start a dignified life. When we came here, life improved greatly, and we finally were sure that we had something to eat daily. Our new life seemed nearly luxurious, and I was proud of my dad for what he had achieved for us in all these years of hard work and suffering. When I went to a new school here in America, I noticed that still there was difference in levels of life between my family and the others. I was wearing the old clothes I was donated, while everyone had new ones. Everyone got smartphones, and I couldn't dream of a phone. I remember that episode when a teacher at school asked everyone who they wanted to become as grown-ups, and everyone said a doctor or a lawyer, while I said I wanted to be a janitor. The teacher started telling me off. She said that a person must be ambitious and aspire to the best. Everyone was laughing at me. I was so embarrassed and sad. I had to respond silently that I wanted to be a janitor just like my dad. It seemed funny to my classmates. And I even got a nickname, the janitor. We had a big family. There were 5 of us siblings, and I was the oldest one. Mom was not working, as she was taking care of the babies, and that salary was not enough. So, still as a child after school and on all the holidays, I started working, mowing neighbors' lawns, cleaning, walking the dogs and things like that. When I was lucky, I even earned a decent sum. I brought all the money I earned home, and they were added to the common budget. I was watching my classmates going on summer vacations with their parents, while I was doing odd jobs from morning till night. But I was not envious at all. I was happy and proud that I had this possibility to contribute, and understood that my earnings made our life a lot easier. Important was that we all loved each other and gave a lot of support to each other. Of course, you can't leave it all work and no play. I had a passion of mine, which was music. I was not very loved at school, and it was so depressing to be isolated from everyone. Music for me was the way to retreat from that all. What I liked the most was playing the trumpet. My music teacher liked me a lot, and she was convinced I was very talented, and she even gave me private lessons for free to help me develop my skills. I was a solo player in the school orchestra and was very proud of it. I imagined my future being a modest worker and maybe playing in some band in the evening, and felt that it would be anything I would need from life. However, turned out that life had other plans for me. My music teacher organized an audition for me at a very famous music college so that I could enter it after school. I actually was very reluctant, as I definitely couldn't afford it, so there was no sense in going there. But she said that sometimes life gives us surprises. I had to go just not to disappoint her. During the audition, they asked me to improvise, and suddenly, due to my nervousness, I got carried away by the music. I thought about my parents, my brothers and sisters, and tried to render this warm feeling into music. The result was breathtaking. Seemed that I managed to impress them. They told me to expect the outcome in a couple of days, and I went home without too much hope. However, when I got a call, I got a proposal that seemed everything I could need from life. To enter the college without tuition, and even with a small scholarship for students in need. I didn't think myself as a huge talent, but clearly, they decided otherwise. But I had to refuse. They thought I misunderstood, but I really refused, as I had enough time to think it over. My family needs me, I explained. I can't let them down. I earn money, and without it, their life will become much harder. I need to contribute, so I'll have to go to work full day as soon as I finish school. They asked me not to refuse immediately, to discuss it with my parents and listen to their opinion. I told my parents about the call, and proudly informed them about my decision. My dad looked at me strange and asked, "Hijo, are you an idiot? This is the chance of your life. Having my children break their backs for a minimal wage is not what I was struggling all these years for. I didn't expect it and was so surprised. When I asked, but I wouldn't be able to contribute. I won't work. Ah, come on. We are adults. We will work out something. We are not starving after all. I am a senior now, and my college is waiting for me. I can't wait. I am practicing music all the time, and I am also working a lot to contribute something before I leave. I see bright future ahead of me, and all this is thanks to my dad. Apart from giving me this opportunity, as a result of his hard work, he taught me that I need to calculate chances and set the priorities, and that it is a shame to waste your talent if you have one. I am sure I will be the most motivated student ever, because when I start work, I would be able to give my family back all the support I have received from them in order to make my dream come true. Hope you find my story inspiring, and if it is so, please put a like and share it with everyone. If you have had similar problems, tell about them in the comments.